See, this program was started 7-8 years back by President NRAI, Ranendra Singh, and it was his brainchild and dream that, you know, to create something which lasts very long. And I think he did the right coach, national shooters, those who were like, did well in the past and in their time, and like Dipali, Suma, Bananjali was approached. And then he gave us a task to start building up this team. And whenever we asked, whatever we asked, we got throughout. It's not that he, in between he did and after not, it was not like that. He always impressed what you want and you don't get it. And when, especially when you see that kids needs more and still they are not getting, and they have a capability, they have a talent, and still we are not able to provide. So you feel sometimes frustrated, and then I had the tendency of reacting. So, but he always helped me, he always calmed me down, and he supported whatever he said. He was a like man of his word. So till now, he's the one who's leading us, encouraging us to get it done. And definitely, see, in our India, we have a lot of talent. It's just that we have to catch them at the right time. And with this program, we did that. And you can see the result coming out now.
So do you feel that it's a time of transition in Indian shooting? And if we talk about last 3 years and now where we are, what do you feel?
I think that it's... So, and we will go a long way this way.
One more thing, I mean, getting benched at training the younger ones, it's good that we have the younger shooters who are always ready to take the challenge, and whenever they are getting the opportunity, they are performing.
No, the best part is not the younger one. There are more. If somebody like this competition, because Mannu had the place, I had the quota place, so they were shooting MQS matches. But that did not stop us not to win those medals also. Yashasvini came from nowhere. Like, she was not in the national team, and then she came in the national team, and she got the quota place, she got the gold medal. So, you know, when you're not depending on one or two names, and there are fleet behind one person, one strong person, so you don't have to worry about, like, one goes out, two other replace. This used to be like China. You know, if one good shooter goes out, and shooter to take the place. Now we are in that place that once good shooter goes out, there are like good number of and who will take, nobody knows. So it's a good thing, and it's a very good for the future. And I'm sure that if we keep doing this and we can protect these kids from outside and from themselves also, we are there.
Yes, sir, one final question. As you know that shooting is excluded from the Commonwealth Games, which will definitely affect the medal tally if we are not shooting there. And do you also feel that it should be boycotted? As IOI said, we should boycott it.
We should not, but as a pistol shooter, I like that, you know, what if tomorrow they take out badminton, what next they take out wrestling. So if they keep on taking out, if there's a justified reason, we are ready to accept. But if there's no justified reason that they don't have money, the England economy depends on the selling of arms and ammunition. What are they talking about? And the place we already shot in that country, Commonwealth Games, right? And we have won. So basically they're trying to just to cut down the medal tally of India. So we have to understand that. And we should do everything and whatever possible way to put the pressure.
One final question to you, awards has been given. Are you disappointed that recognition is not being given to you because of, like, I mean, your hard work, everything is there. But are you, like, disappointed?
See, that I think this event is not about that, so I don't think that's a right place to answer that. Thank you very much.
Thank you.